Greetings everyone. In this video, we are going to see heuristic methods that we can use for solving the TSP problem. One of the heuristics is the nearest neighbor heuristic and the other one is the reversal heuristic. The idea in the nearest neighbor heuristic is to start from a home city, then visit the next nearest city, and from that city, you visit the next unvisited nearest city. And you follow this chain until you come back to the home city. So that is the idea in the nearest neighbor heuristic. In the reversal heuristic, the idea is, given a tour, select some of the arcs and reverse them. And you get another solution. And then you follow this procedure systematically to obtain a greedy solution. Now let us look at the nearest neighbor heuristic. Here we have an example of a 5-city problem and here is the data matrix. And here are the steps for the nearest neighbor heuristic. Let us pick node number 1 as the start city. Now in this matrix, we will eliminate the column for city 1. We are eliminating city 1 because we do not want to come back to city 1 until we finish the entire tour. Now from city 1, the nearest city is city number 3. So let us eliminate city number 3. And from city 3, the nearest unvisited city will be city number 4. Let us eliminate city number 4. And from city 4, the nearest unvisited city will be city number 2. And from city 2, the nearest unvisited city will be city number 5. And from 5, you will come back to city 1. So that will give you a nearest neighbor tour for this problem. Similarly, from city number 2, the nearest unvisited city will be city number 5. So you eliminate the column of city 2 and city number 5 will be the next city. From city 5, the nearest unvisited column will be city 1. From city 1, the nearest unvisited column will be city 3. From city 3, the nearest unvisited city will be city 4. And from city 4, you will come back to city number 2. So the nearest neighbor tour from city 2 will be 251342. Now I repeat this procedure starting from all the possible cities. For example, here we have city number 3, 4 and 5 and these are the corresponding nearest neighbor tours. And from these we'll pick the minimum. For instance, here we have 3 minimum. And this is the greedy solution or the nearest neighbor solution. Since there is a tie, we can pick any of these two arbitrarily and declare it as our best solution. Now let us look at the idea of the reversal heuristic. A reversal is nothing but reversing the arcs in the tour. For example, consider this tour. Now let us try to write a neighbor. For example, here, if you look at this tour, the arc 3-4 is reversed and you have here 4-3. Such a related tour for this tour is called as a neighbor tour and it is a 2-at-a-time reversal. Graphically, this is how they look. This is your initial tour and this is the 2-at-a-time reversal tour. Let us try to write all the 2-at-a-time reversal tours. So you could have a reversal here or you could have a reversal here or you could have a reversal here or you could have a reversal here. So you'll have 4 2-at-a-time reversals. And these are those 4-at-a-time reversals. Now let us write all the 3-at-a-time reversals. So what will be those 3-at-a-time reversals? Well, you could have a reversal like this. Or a reversal like this. or a reversal like this. So in total you will have three at a time reversals, and these are those reversals. You can see here, this is a reversal corresponding to the red reversal, and this is a corresponding blue reversal, and this is a corresponding green reversal. And for this reversal, here is the graphical representation. Now let us write all the four at a time reversals. And here we'll have these two 4 at a time reversals. For the 5 at a time reversal, we'll have this candidate. Now this candidate will not be a new reversal until and unless the distance from 6 to 5 is different from the distance from 5 to 6. The distance from 5 to 4 is different from distance 4 to 5. So on and so forth. And this can only happen when the formulation is not symmetric. So basically, for a 6 city problem, 5 at a time reversal can only occur when the problem is asymmetric. Otherwise, you will have maximum 4 at a time reversal. So to summarize, for an n city problem, you will have maximum n minus 2 at a time reversal for symmetric TSP, and you will have n minus 1 at a time reversals for asymmetric TSP. Now given a tour, all the reversals are nothing but the neighbors of the current tour. And the idea of the reversal heuristic is to execute a greedy search. And we have seen the concept of greedy search in our heuristics chapter. Let us take an example and see how the reversal heuristics work. Here we have the same 5 city TSP problem with the data. And here are the steps for the reversal heuristic. Let us start from some initial tour. Let us say that's our initial tour. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and the objective function value is 29. From this tour, we are trying to build all the reversals. So these are the 2 at a time reversal. These are the 3 at a time reversal. These are the 4 at a time reversal. Since this is a 5 city asymmetric TSP problem, we can have maximum 4 at a time reversals. So these are all the possible reversals of our initial tour. From all these reversals, we'll pick the best one, and it turns out to be Z equals to 23. We have 2 possible candidates. So let us pick one of them arbitrarily, and that will be the current solution or the current tour for the next iteration. And then we repeat this procedure on and on until you hit some termination criteria. What we have seen is just one iteration. And from the knowledge of heuristic methods, you can build the greedy approach. Here is the summary of the first iteration. Here is the tour, and here is the objective function value. In the second iteration, that's the current tour and the corresponding objective function value. And in the third iteration, that's the current tour and the corresponding objective function value. Now, when I created the reversals for this tour, I found no improvement. So that is where I stopped and concluded that I have a local optimum solution. Now the last part of this chapter is about some of the research directions for the TSP problem. Like we discussed in one of the earlier videos, we have upper bound and lower bound, 2 different directions where you can improve the TSP solution method, and all the details are given in the references. In the following slide, we are going to see the largest overlapping circles idea. The idea is very simple. Let us say these are the cities. Then we are trying to place circles around the cities such that the radius of these circles is as high as possible. However, those circles should not intersect. So using this idea, we could generate a lower bound on the TSP problem, and that will be 2 times the sum of all radii. And this is the formulation that will help us in obtaining the maximum value for the lower bound. It is a simple linear program. You see the variables are all non-negative variables, and we have all linear constraints. The right hand side in each of these constraints is a constant value. So it's a simple linear program to solve. And this method will give you a lower bound for the TSP problem. This is a generic representation of the same formulation. Sometimes the lower bound that we obtain here is very good, sometimes it is not.
For example, here the lower bound is very loose.
And here are all the references that went in to build this chapter. If you have any questions, any comments, please let me know via email, or you can write the comments below the video. That is all what we have in this chapter. Hope you understood the concepts of this chapter. If you find these videos useful, then please like and subscribe to my channel.